Hello friends, welcome to my channel TextileGAN. I am Prakash Kude, Assistant Professor in MLA Textile Engineering College, Bhilwara, Rajasthan. Today we'll basically talk about the negative let-up motion. In my last video, we have basically seen the objective of your let-up motion. What are the different types of let-up motion, that is your negative let-up and positive let-up. So now we'll see the working principle of your negative let-up. So in negative let-up motion, I already said the warp beam is not driven positively. So warp beam in this case is driven by dragging of the cloth and the warp sheet by the takeoff motion. So ultimately the warp sheet has been released from your viewer's beam due to the dragging of your cloth by the takeoff motion. And if you are dragging this cloth at the front, so due to that the tension has been exerted on your warp sheet. So the releasing of your warp sheet has been done from your viewer's beam negatively. There will not be any drive system is there. So due to this take-up motions, ultimately the die goes to your let-up. So in this case, the warp tension and the delivery of warp is controlled by using your wet and lever systems. So however, this system doesn't give a uniform delivery and uniform tension over your all the warp ends. So that is a basic disadvantage of your negative let-up motion. But for the production of your light and medium weight fabric, we go for your negative let-up motion. So now you'll see what is the construction of your negative let-up motion. We are seeing the right hand side view of your negative let-up motion. So in this viewer beam A has a beam barrel, that is your B. So beam barrel, and it has the flanges C at its end. Only one flange here we can see in this figure, and the other flange is on your other side of your beam. So this is like the one construction. These are the flanges of your beams are there. This is your viewer's beam and having the two flanges at the end, and this distance between these two flanges has been adjusted to suit the required width of your warp sheet. So that can be adjusted as per your required width of your warp sheet. Next to your flange, there is a ruffle. Here in this figure, we can also see there's a ruffle is there. Here in this also, this is your beam and this is your beam flange C. And at the other side, we have the ruffle, which is K is here we have mentioned in this figure. And this ruffle, which is over your, which has the chain or which has been wound on it, this ruffle. And one end of your chain has been connected with your loom frame. Here we can see the one end of your chain has been wound here. And another end of your chain has been connected with the hook E. This is a wet lever hook normally called as a, which is connected with your the lever, long wet lever F, with the help of your pin. J is the pin and this is connected with your lever. So in this case, the one end of your chain has been wound with your loom frame, and another end, which is about 1.5 to 2 rounds has been wound on your ruffle and is connected with your hook. And this hook is connected to your long lever F by means of pin J, and which is resting on one of your notches of your lever F. So this lever has a fulcrum H and the wet G is hang on this lever. So this similar arrangement has been there on the other side of your loom also, where this ruffle has been there, the chain has been wound on this other side of your flange. The similar arrangement has been there on the other side also, that is left hand side of your loom. So this beam flange can vary from your 12 inches to the 18 inch in your diameter depending upon your the amount of warp sheet which has been wound on your viewer's beam. So now you'll see the basic working principle of your negative let up motions, where we have seen this negative let up motions works by your pulling action of your takeoff motion. In my last video also we have seen that the motion is not the positive in nature. It has been done by your pulling or dragging action of your takeoff motion. As the cloth roller rotates, it pulls your warp sheet from the reverse beam, and due to that the dragging of your warp sheet has been taken place. So when loom is in action or operation, the diameter has been reduces gradually, and if the weight on this lever has been kept fixed, the tension on your warp sheet has been increases considerably. So basically yahan pe kya hota hai, jab bhi tumhara beam start ho raha hai, if it is at the full stage, your tension on your beam has been low, so at the same time the releasing amount we need to do is less. As the diameter has been dropped down, so tension on your warp sheet has been increases as the diameter has been reduces. So due to during that period we need to release this warp sheet, the speed of your reverse beam should be more. In that case n should be more as d has been reduces. So basically we are controlling this releasing amount of your warp sheet from your reverse beam has been done in case of your negative let up motion, unless and until the tension on your warp sheet has been taken place, the releasing of your warp sheet has not been done. So ultimately with this help of this weight and lever systems, we are controlling the movement of your reverse beam. So if you are not doing this, so that will ultimately causes the shuttle trap and variation in your fix per inch and the warp breakages. So to maintain this uniform tension and avoid this variation of your fix per inch and shuttle trap and warp breakages, we need to do the following things on your weight and lever systems. Because if there is a variation in tension or the releasing amount can vary, so during that these are the defects which can be possible in case of your negative let up motion. So to avoid this, we need to adopt the following things. One, we need to decrease the amount of weight on the lever. Second is we need to alter the position of your weight on the lever. And third is we need to change the position of your pin on the lever. And the fourth variation we can do, the way we do the increase and decreasing the number of turns of chains which has been wound on your ruffle. So that means the first thing we need to do is we need to decrease the amount of your weight as soon as the beam has been exhausted or it has been the diameter has been reduced. Second thing, we need to change this position of your weight on this lever. Third is we can change the position of the pin of your hook on this lever. And fourth is we need to increase or decrease the number of chains around the ruffle. So out of these four, the best way to get the uniform tension or avoid this about defects is we can do the altering position of your weight on the lever. So this is the second method which you have adopted to reduce the tension in the warp sheet as the diameter has been decreases. Because that is practically, other methods are practically impossible. So whenever the weight has been moved towards the fulcrum point, so warp tension has been reduces, and so that has been done by your weavers. And the shifting of your weight on the lever should be done simultaneously on the both the side of your beam, or else the irregular tension will be developed in the warp, which may not be regulated evenly. So ultimately when we are moving this weight on the lever, we need to do simultaneously on the both the side, right hand side and both and left hand side also, so that we the uniform tension has been maintained on your warp sheet, and the releasing amount which you need to release for the into the your viewing array has been done perfect. So these are the things we have seen in this negative let off motions that has been done by your the things which you need to move on this lever has been done by the viewers, and we need to do this simultaneously on the both these side. So this let off motion is your negative let off motion as it is comes into the action as soon as the result of your take off motion has been done. So it is not the positive drive has been given to your negative let off motion. So now we'll see what are the advantages and the defects of your negative let off motion. The first advantage of your negative let off motion is it is simple in construction and cheap. Second, it is basically used for your light and medium weight fabric. And third is it facilitates the beaming of your tender warp. The defects in the negative let off motions are the tension in the warp cannot be kept uniform since the weight has been moved manually. As we are doing this, the weight has been shifted manually, so there could be chances that the tension on the warp sheet cannot be kept uniformly. The first defect has been there. Second is due to the irregular tension in the warp sheet, the shuttle trap or variation in peaks per inch and the warp breakage can be occurs. So these are the defects has been occurred in case of your negative let off motions. Third is there is a difficulty in regulating the tension in the warp sheet during the start of your beam. Initially the beam has the high at the full stage, so during that case time there could be the chances that variation in your warp sheet could be there. So these are the advantages and disadvantages or defects in the negative let off motions. So we have seen that what is the basic working principle of your negative let off motion. As the diameter we need to be decreases, we need to release or we can shift that dead weights which has been put on your lever towards the fulcrum point, because initially the dead weight position is near away from your fulcrum point. During that period the tension is higher. So as diameter has been decreases, the releasing amount should be more, or you can say the n should be increases. So due to that we need to shift that dead weights. So that is practically possible case, because if you see that the changing of your dead weights is difficult. The second is the number of coils on your chain which has been wound on the ruffle, that is also not possible. Third, we have seen that the position of your pin where the hook has been attached to the lever. So these are the things which are not be possible practically. So the best way to change the dead weights on your lever so that we can get the uniform tension and uniform releasing rate of your warp sheet to the viewing area. So thank you so much guys for your kind attention. Stay tuned to my channel Textile Gyan. Don't forget to subscribe my channel. Also like, share and comment on this.